Hello friends, I am Professor Viresh Yam Hiramat, working in the Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering, SG Balaikundri Institute of Technology, Belagavi. Today we will discuss about a topic from the subject Analog Circuits of 4th semester from the module 5, that is Operational Amplifier Circuits. Today we will discuss about the DAC using weighted resistor. DAC is a circuit that converts a digital inputs into an analog output. And there are many methods of converting a given digital input to analog output. And one of those methods is using weighted resistors. You can see the figure, which is using an operational amplifier in the inverting configuration. There is a feedback resistor RF of 1 kilo ohms. And in addition to this, there are four more resistances, R, R by 2, R by 4, and R by 8. Because of these values of resistances, it is called weighted resistor. Now let us assume the value of R as 10 kilo ohms, therefore R by 2 will be 5 kilo ohms, R by 4 will be 2.5 kilo ohms, R by 8 will be 1.25 kilo ohms. Here the digital inputs are B0, B1, B2 and B3, where B0 is the least significant bit and B3 is the most significant bit. Now depending on the value of the digital input 0 or 1, the switch is either open circuited or closed circuited. If the bit is 1, then the current flows through the resistance, and if the bit is 0, no current flows through the resistance. And as you can see, the operational amplifier is operated in the inverting configuration. Therefore, the output expression is given by minus RF into the input that is applied at the input terminals. Now let us see the different conditions. The first one, if B0 equal to 1, here we have considered B0 as the least significant bit. When B0 equal to 1, the current flows through the resistor R, and the value of current can be found by writing 5 minus 0 divided by 10 kilo ohms. 5 is the supply, 0 is the voltage at the terminal V2, and 10 kilo ohm is the resistance. From this, we will get the current value as 0.5 milliamperes. Now, as the input resistance of the operational amplifier is infinity, the entire current flows through the feedback resistor RF, and the output voltage V0 can be got by multiplying I and RF. So I is 0.5 milliamperes and RF is 1 kilo ohm. So you get the value output as minus 0.5 volts if B0 equal to 1. Consider the next case, if B1 equal to 1. Now if the digital input bit B1 equal to 1, then the current flows through R by 2 resistance, and the current can be calculated as 5 minus 0 divided by 5 kilo ohms, which is 1 milliamperes. Now again, as the input resistance of the operational amplifier is infinity, the entire current flows through the feedback resistor RF. And again, the output voltage V0 can be calculated as the current flowing through the resistance into the resistance value, that is 1 milliamps into 1 kilo ohms, that is equals to minus 1 volt output for B1 equal to 1. Next case, if B2 equal to 1. If B2 equal to 1, then the current flows through the R by 4 resistance, and the current value is found as 5 minus 0 divided by 2.5 kilo ohms, which gives 2 milliamperes. As we know, the input resistance of operational amplifier is infinity. The entire current again flows through the feedback resistor RF. And the output voltage V0 is given by minus 2 volt if B2 equal to 1. Now next case, B3 equal to 1. Now B3 is the MSP, and when B3 is made as 1, the current flows through the R by 8 resistor, which is of 1.25 kilo ohms. Now the current that flows through the resistance is given by 5 minus 0 divided by 1.25 kilo ohms, which gives us the value as 4 milliamperes. Now again, as the input resistance of the operational amplifier is infinity, the entire current flows through the feedback resistor RF, and we can calculate the output voltage as current into resistance, that is current is 4 milliamperes and the resistance is 1 kilo ohm. So you will get the output of minus 4 volts if P3 is equal to 1. In the same way, we can vary the bits B0, B1, B2, B3 from 0000 to 1111, and we can tabulate the readings as 0 minus 0.5 as shown in the last column, that is V0. Here you can observe that For B naught equal to 1, we had got minus 0.5. For B1 equal to 1, we had got it as minus 1. For B2 equal to 1, we had got it as minus 2. And for B3 equal to 1, we had got it as minus 4. For an example, if all B0, B1, B2, B3 all are 1, that is the serial number 16, we will be getting the value of minus 7.5 because we will be adding minus 0.5, minus 1, minus 2 and minus 4. Therefore, we will be getting minus 7.5 when all the values B0, B1, B2, B3 are 1. And we can draw the graph of input versus output as shown in the figure. So in the 0, when all the inputs are 0, output voltage was 0. And when we change the input from 0000 to 0001, we got it as minus 5 volts and so on. So we can plot these graph as the input versus output voltage. Now, the disadvantages of this technique of converting digital to analog conversion. Now here the circuit was for 4 bits and we were using 4 resistances. Now as the number of bits increases, the circuit becomes more and more complex. And for 8-bit DAC, 8 resistances are values are required with weighted values, which is very difficult to get. Thank you.